Hi, my name is Kevin Vanden Elzen of the West Coast Jazz Hour. And today we'll be talking about a really great drummer who is very underrated and doesn't get talked about a whole lot anymore. And his name was Stan Levy. And Stan was called the original because he was one of the first white bebop drummers that came to the scene. He played in the early 50s with Charlie Parker and Dizzy Gillespie, went on a tour with Diz to Los Angeles. And after that tour, he actually stayed in Los Angeles for a while and made a career as a bebop drummer and became one of the first drummers to play with the Lighthouse All-Stars. And in my opinion, he is really, really a great drummer because he is one of the early users of bebop phrases, both in big band and in small group. And the first thing that I'm going to show you are three 4-bar fills that he uses on a Shorty Rogers record. It's called the Shorty Rogers Express. And the track that he plays these fills are on a composition called Pay the Piper, which is an original composition by Shorty Rogers. And the 4 bars will go like this. I will start playing 4 bars of time first, then the 4 bars of fill, 4 bars of time, 4 bars of fill, etc. Now, what is super cool to me in these 3 4-bar fills is that he's showing a lot of explosiveness to his playing. Jeff Hamilton, who is a mentor of mine, has a theory that Stan came off of the tour with Stan Kenton, and that Shorty Rogers actually asked him to play with the same or a similar kind of explosiveness to his fills and to his playing, which you can really tell in those recordings. And I very much like in the second 4-bar fill that he plays this phrase that goes in between the snare drum and the bass drum. And it's pretty much a 16th note phrase. So the phrase goes like this, slowly. And when you play that faster, 1, 2, 3, 4. Then you create really a nice 16th note phrase that will sound very hip because you can immediately use that over the drums. So that's one of the cool things that I really took out of these 4-bar fills. And the next solo that I'm actually going to show you are also trades of Stan Levy, but you can find these trades on a recording of the Richie Kamuka Quartet, and the tune is Just Friends. Now, those trades of Stan Levy are a very, very good example of using bebop language in the early days of bebop, because Stan started to play bebop in the early 50s when he was starting to play with Bird and Diz on 52nd Street. And there are a couple of phrases to me that really speak out. The first thing that I think is very hip is that in between the trades, he doesn't really leave the ride cymbal, but he keeps on comping and makes it sort of a busy comping solo. And he does that specifically in the fourth staff, or in the fourth trade. And slow, it goes like this. One, two, one, two, three, four. Now, slow, it doesn't really stand out as a solo, but as you know, he plays that at a faster tempo. And it kind of reminded me of what Roy Haynes was doing in those days already, what he was starting to do. And later on, you can really hear that with Bill Stewart, who starts to play a ride cymbal and does all kinds of phrases with his left hand. So I thought that it was very neat to discover about Stan that he was already doing pretty hip stuff while keeping the time going in his right hand and then playing phrases in his left hand. A more solo version of a trade that he does is the second trades. And you can really tell that he does a specific triplet phrase. And I believe that he does that right, right, left, right, like this. One, two, three, four. Right, right, left, right. And he turns that also into a cross rhythm, which he does in the second trades, and he also does that in the fifth row of trades. In the second, he does this. One, two, three, four. Which is over the hi-hat. In the fifth phrase, he does this. Now when you speed that up, one, two, two, three, four. You already get a phrase that's over the bar line, and then you end pretty much on the floor tom, what he does. So I thought that was really cool to find out about Stan, and definitely these phrases are very, very, very applicable to up-tempo jazz playing. So those are some licks and solo phrases by the great Stan Levy.